everyone. My name is Colleen. Thank you for joining me today for 15 minutes of all balance, all focus, and all body weight training. All you'll need, in addition to yourself, is a simple yoga block or a light object that is lightweight, doesn't add a ton of weight, because we're going to be working on not falling over, being more functionally fit, better everyday living, just to move better. Traditionally, usually balance work is best done barefoot or in socks. So if you can get in bare feet or in socks safely, join me there. And then grab your yoga block, and all I want you to do is start by turning in a position that allows you to have the block right at your chest, and roll the shoulders back and down. Align the shoulder, hip, knees are softly bent and heels are grounded, toes can pop up. And then think about the belly button, draw it into the lower back, protect that spine. And then think about your big toe and your little toe. Spread them really wide, because think about points of contact on the floor. Balance. This block. I want you to go ahead, think about hinging like a deadlift, so tail feathers to the ceiling. Drop it. So if I'm facing you, I want you to drop it down. Stand all the way up. Feel your hamstrings. Then I want you to reach down and go. Make sure that block is really close to the leg. So from the side, think flat back, shoulders back. Toes hip high. This is warming you up for where you're about to go in. Then next time you have the block, I need you to get it in your left hand. I want you to step the feet about hip wide, toes to knee. And all I need you to do is take that block out to the outside of the leg. And I want you to think about reaching up. That means straight up overhead. And then I want you to think about your right leg. Left leg stays planted, left arm has the block. Reach, point. Opposite, can you hold, contract the core? And then from here, think about reaching, lifting, tapping if you need to, working on balance and strength and stability to the core. Hinge at your hips. Tap. Up. Three times. One more. Slow and control. Up. Step in and just switch your sides. Find your feet. Spread your toes wide. Shoulders down and back. Flat back. Think about the block overhead first. Make sure your shoulders are out of the ears. Jaw is soft and relaxed. Step your left foot back. Hinge like a single leg deadlift, but you reach forward this time. And if you can, I want you to see if you can touch that block to the floor for me. And then up. Can you let your back foot float? Give me three of your best. After you're tired, that means you're first. I want three, work, and then step in. Now, I want you to think. Block from the floor all the way down. That means the flattest part, the widest part. And I want you to go ahead and step over your right side, feet are parallel, straight to me, weight in the heels. Crowd posture, belly button in. And all I need you to do is think about the foot that is furthest away. Give me that right leg, lift it. Two legs five. You're already here. I need you to catch yourself. Bend your leg that's closest to the block on the left side. Can you bend down? Make your block. Stand and then feet underneath of the the right side, and then you can place it down, and then I want you to get low again. And then you're here, and this is your free trouble. You started super tough, but you have levels, and that's the block. So now you only have to go, and maybe this is more manageable for you. Wobbly moving around, which is tough, but balance, it's earned and it's progressed. Low, meander, drop your block, step to the other side. So, spread your toes wide. Is your forehead still soft? Dog, relax. Shoulders back. Figure out. Where does your block need to be? What level works best for you? Are you sitting back, chest proud? Ready? Left hand outside leg. Left leg up. Right foot down. Sink down. Balance is different side to side. Grab it. Under. Down low. Up. Stay low. Single leg squat. If that meant to be easy, balance. I need you to mentally mind body. Focus, connect the two. You have three more, guys. Get there. Use your arms. Your levers. And it's the weight shift. You need to tap down. Always do it. Don't injure yourself. Always check your ego at the door. One more. Can you pick your block up one more time? Do you feel your standing cast? Feed it. Good step wide. Balance. So, part of the balance is single leg, low, tapping. You've done that. However, what else do you have to do sometimes? Sometimes you're going to step, you might slide, and you need to catch yourself. So I want you to give yourself your yoga block, and think of it as an obstacle that is in your leg. Stomach flat, straight on, step feet outside, like your insoles are hugging the block. Then I want you to go ahead and just step over to your right, wide. Over, catch your knee. Hold for two. One step over. Over again, wider. Catch your left. Heel. Rise your right leg. Flow. Are you in your left heel? Toes can they move? Now, step only outside of the block. Now step that right leg just a little wider. Catch that heel and pull that leg up. Can you breathe? Can you make it a reaction? Now step wide and step right there, and then I want you to make a reaction. So I'll bend in the long leg. React. Three, two, one. Step wide right. You're almost done because we only have 15 minutes together. So, I need you to think. Shoulders back. Face is relaxed. Wiggle out anything that you're holding stress in. Toes are wide. Give me that hinge tail feather to the ceiling. Soften in the knees. Reach for your block. And then I want you to go ahead on the way up. A pistol squat. Up with the block straight, like just like a front raise, and then think about taking your right leg out. Out. So if the pistol squat bothers the knee, what do? You let your foot slide. It slides. And then maybe you're like, okay, I'm gonna try one of the lifts, and then you're like, oh, you need to drop, balance. But I want you to 4, 3, 2, 1. Together, hinge, full deadlift. Slow control, squeeze your glutes, belly button and shoulder flat. Front raise, pistol squat. Bend your knee, send the foot to me. So one side's different than the other. They are not the same. Out and in. Feel your hips, feel your quad. Give me 4, 3, 2, 1. Deep breath if you're here. Turtle shell. Curl. Belly button in. Mike Tyson punch. Are you bracing for it? And I'm just like hanging out, right? Strong core, foundation of your body. And on that note, balance. So if you need a mat for your tailbone, you won't be on the ground for long because sometimes you gotta get off the ground and it requires that. So I want you to go ahead, cross your feet, sit down, lift your block. You take the arms out of the equation. Can you sit softly, slow? So when you're here, I want you to think. Okay. Now can you stand up, block here, by just crossing your feet. Think about being here. Can you cross your feet just like you sat and stand by rocking forward, using the core strength, pressing into the floor, standing up. Core strength, balance, legs. Now cross the legs the opposite way. Bend your knees, sit down slow. Down, 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 lower. Like muscle, not momentum. Take a seat. 3, 2, tell yourself you can, you will. Up. Now this side's harder. If you're like, I can't get up. Pop the hand down, lift. But if you can, I need you to think. Cross. It gives yourself that cross to lean into. Then lean in. And always reach. Strong back. Strong core. Reach, stand. Like you see, sometimes you're gonna falter, sometimes you're gonna slip. But if you can get above the floor, life changing. And it slows down the process of aging. So now, I need you to sit back. So from the side, I want you to think, legs straight, block at your chest. Sit back, one block. Here. Now, can you rock onto your back very slowly? Back flat. Can you rock up? Now, can you simply stand up? I don't care if you have to cross your legs, but if you can you think about pulling in, crossing, standing, and turn? Like you're walking in the other direction, that's it. Sit back. Gotta get out of bed super fast and sit up. How are you gonna get up? Is it this? Is it this? However you can get up the most safe. Joints feel okay. Cross your legs. Use your block for a little bit of pull forward. You press. Stand. Now, have some balance work. You're gonna see later. But what I need you to do for me one more time. You heard them. Hips. So, take your hand, give me the block. Put it on the floor, give me flat. Nice flat block. And I want you to step on your outside, inside, hands to your hips. Can you just squat low? Stand, tap the top, tie knee. And then think about extending to the side, flex your foot. Use your core. You have 5, 2, 1, drop your foot, squat low, stand tall, lift your right leg, flex foot, kick it out, brace the core, breathe every time, shoulders. I want you to clasp your hands round to me and then overhead down. Again, clasp the hands to me. Then take the hands heart center, pull it in and pull it back. In, back. Pinch to the shoulder blades. And then just shake the shoulders, wiggle your toes. Make sure all the toes that you started class with are still attached to your feet. And then just shake the neck out and roll the shoulders. Thank you all very much for spending 15 minutes with me today for total balance work. Every time we do this, it's different. But every time we do it, it leads to a more functional, fit, everyday life. Remember to rehydrate, stretch if you need to, but most importantly, take care, stay well, and I'll see each and every one of you again real soon.